So what do we have today, PKR? The mystery?
Well, Devang, it's not so much of a mystery to a lot of users. It's something which has really been revolutionizing computers over the last few years, mm-hmm. and it's called multimedia. What we are going to look at today is the spectrum of multimedia products that are changing the way the user interacts with his PC.
Oh, so we're talking about multimedia upgrades?
Yes, we are.
Oh, I see.
It's a great new thing, and it's such a major new segment and new products. Today, you don't really think of multimedia as a new thing or a separate segment at all. Why? Because it's part of every PC. It's part of almost every PC that sells to the home segment. It's part of a lot of PCs that go into offices. It goes into every notebook, whether it's a PC or Macintosh or whatever, it's got multimedia in it. So you're absolutely correct that it is definitely so integrated into your PC that you don't think of it as separate. But what we are going to look at is what happens to all those, you know, older users of PCs, because they don't have, they came from the PCs came from a time when there was no multimedia. So that is, I think, what is exciting about the fact that you can do upgrades to those PCs.
So what kind of computers can be upgraded?
Well, you can upgrade pretty much any type of computer, but you may not be able to directly put in multimedia stuff like, you know, CD ROM drives and so on, which we'll talk about.
So let's talk about what are the various components of the multimedia.
Okay. Multimedia, essentially, that first thing to look at is what is multimedia. It's when you add other dimensions, you know, beyond text and graphics to the computer. You add sound, you add video. So therefore, you need things which can produce that sound and that video. One of the first things is that you need a sound card inside your PC, so that a PC which is normally not equipped to handle sound is able to work with a sound card which looks something like this. Okay. And this is something that goes into the PC. Okay, so this is what you need to start out with, and these are really cheap these days. You know, they can be 600-700 rupees, 800 rupees. So this is the first step. What you would do is then you'd be able to connect speakers like this into that. You'd be able to connect maybe a headset like this, so that, you know, you can put it on and listen to it and you can talk into it. And finally, another major component of multimedia today is you know, CD-ROM drives, which look like this. Again, you can buy drives which stay outside your computer, but it's much more convenient to actually buy a drive which is installed in your computer, because then it becomes a part of your PC. And so essentially, in a multimedia kit, if you were to buy a whole box, I've got a box here which looks something like this. It's a huge box, but what it really has in it is these components. It's got
a full multimedia kit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A CD-ROM drive, sound card, speakers, and a headset. A kit like this is going to land up costing about maybe 8,000 to 12,000 rupees.
The complete kit.
The complete kit. Mm-hmm. Now, that's if you want to go all the way and put in sound and, you know, CD-ROM drive and whatever else. But you might want to start smaller. For instance, you might simply want to be able to read CD-ROMs. Today, a lot of software comes on CD-ROMs. Then you can add just a CD-ROM drive. And this is not going to cost you more than about 3,000 to 3,500 today.
Okay.
Now, this is a remarkable thing, because these drives used to cost 8,000, 9,000, 10,000 about 2 years ago. And today they're 3,000. Today you can get drives starting at 2,000 rupees. So suddenly, just by spending 2,000 rupees, you can add the capability to read CD-ROMs. The next thing you might want to add is a sound card, which would be another 800-900 rupees.
Mm. PKR, are these standard speakers which are used in the music system, or one has to buy a different kind of speakers?
Well, actually, these speakers are really not very different. They're made a little specially for computer systems, in the sense that they're made small and they're made to match the color of your computer
system.
But
you can use the audio speakers.
You can use audio speakers. What you do have to watch for is that the impedance matches the impedance of the card. So you have 8 ohm, 16 ohm, and so on. And if you do want good quality sound, actually, you have to go to those slightly larger and better speakers. You can connect this to an audio system too.
We have spoken about audio. We have not spoken about video. Now, do you have different kind of systems which, for example, the DVD technology, has that come onto a PC very strongly where a normal user can use it?
Absolutely. That's something that's happening now, that the CD-ROM drive itself, although it can store 500 to 600 megabytes of stuff.
This has 8x on that, on the CD.
Yeah, that means it's 8 times faster than the oldest CD-ROM drives which came out.
So how much more do you...
It goes up to 32x today. They're going up even beyond that to 44x. Now, this is not fast enough for video. It's just about okay for video. But the bigger problem is that, in terms of capacity, you can't really store more than maybe 15-20 minutes of live video on one CD. So that's when you need what you're talking about, a DVD-ROM drive. Mm-hmm. Now you can buy a DVD-ROM drive and you can add it to your PC. You'll notice that it looks rather like the CD-ROM drive
here.
But it can take a DVD-ROM disk. Today, there are a lot of drives like this. Now, these cost a little more. These are probably in the 6,000 to 9,000 range. Now, once you have this, you can use a DVD disk on which you can have a full video. That means maybe a 2-hour or a 3-hour video entirely on the disk. And instead of just 600 megabytes, you can store up to 2, 3 gigabytes, up to 17 gigabytes theoretically
on one
disk.
But you can't run a CD, a normal CD-ROM on that.
You can have just one drive.
You don't require a CD-ROM drive.
Yeah, that's right.
Can you convert a 286 machine or a 386 into a multimedia compatible?
In theory, yes. In practice, you'll have to change pretty much everything. The 286 itself won't be able to take it. So you change the board. You'd spend maybe 5,000-6,000 rupees on a Pentium board or a Pentium class board.
It might be a good idea to replace the whole system there.
Yes, you'd still save some money. I mean, within maybe 7,000 to 8,000 rupees, you could add a board, a processor, RAM, and take it up to a stage where it's ready for multimedia.
Can you tell us more about the future trends in the multimedia upgrades so that people can watch out for them?
Well, first of all, you do need to, it's a good idea to go step by step in this because although obsolescence happens very quickly in technology, it's not something that you keep waiting for that one fine day you will get something that which is not going to get obsoleted. But in the immediate future, you do have the DVD-ROM drive, you've got faster cards which are coming up, faster video handling capability, faster sound, and a lot of sound recognition capability which might get integrated into the sound card itself.
Thank you, PKR, for coming to us every week and giving us your expert advice.
Thank you once again.
PKR never ceases to amaze me. But coming up next on the show are the headlines from the world of information technology.
The Department of Telecommunication, DOT, has asked Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, VSNL, to further reduce telecom accounting rates. Despite large-scale reforms in the IT industry, the government is not likely to allow internet telephony in the near future. The Department of Telecommunication, DOT, has decided to do away with a premium on leased lines rentals from electronics mail service providers. The Government of India and the Indian business community have jointly proposed to institutionalize the Indo-Kenyan Commercial Alliance to help the Kenyan software industry.